Hey y'all, today I'm going to take a look at the Creality Ender3 version 3 KE model 3D printer. This is a series that I think it's safe to say it's one of the foundations of 3D printing technology. Even if the title of the video doesn't say Ender 3, I'm sure many 3D printer users would understand that we're talking about the Ender 3 series. Numerous models of this series are available. Today I'll examine the Creality Ender 3 V3 KE, an entry-level printer known for its fast printing capabilities. Now let's briefly review the features of this printer. Afterwards, I'll share with you the sample prints I took, the speed tests I conducted, and my thoughts on the printer. The design of the Ender 3 V3 KE consists of smooth flowing lines. While plastic is used in the main body and horizontal top profile, T-shaped aluminum profiles are preferred in the vertical profiles. The printer, which is tidy, has a width and depth of 43.3 by 36.6 centimeters and a height of 49 centimeters. And the height is also 49 centimeters. They used a flexible PEI coating as a build plate. This table makes it easier for the material to adhere strongly to the surface, especially when working on materials such as PLA, and it can be easily removed when the build plate cools down. With KE, you can get prints with a width and depth of up to 22 centimeters and a height of up to 24 centimeters. An important change in the series is related to the movement mechanism of the build plate. The brand, which is gradually eliminating wheeled systems, aims to achieve a more stable movement on this model by using steel shafts and bearings for build plate movement. Leveling is completely automatic. The printer is taking measurements from multiple points on the build table using both the CR touch and pressure sensitive systems at the same time. Another point where the wheel system is left behind is the print head. We can see that the movement in X axis is now taking place on a linear rail. In the extruder section, they're using the Sprite extruder, a lightweight and powerful system developed by Creality that we're used to seeing in the Ender and CR series. In the Hotend section, we see the 60-watt ceramic heater system used by Creality in its upper segment printers such as K1 and K1 Max. The printhead moves in the Z axis using a single motor on both sides, which is located on the trapezoidal threaded rod. And the power is transferred to the counter shaft through a belt connection on a single engine. The control of the device, which has a clipper-based software, is done through a 4.3-inch color touchscreen. This screen, which has a simple and easy-to-use interface, also supports many languages. The printer has wireless connectivity. With this feature, we can send models to our printer via the network using Creality Print. You can start and stop the printing or make instant interventions to settings like temperature, speed, fan, and control the printing status. And if you want, you can also integrate Creality's AI camera, which is offered as an optional feature, into this printer and control your prints through the same system or even shoot time-lapse videos. These features are integrated so that the printer can reach high speeds. KE can reach speeds as high as 500 millimeters per second with an acceleration of 8,000 millimeters square per second. This printer, which we can label as entry-level, also has impressive features. a few dots that may raise a question in your mind. I will address all of these in the later parts of the video, but first let's see how the printer has performed in printings. Let's begin examining with the test prints I just got. I think everyone can predict the first edition now. The benchy boat model that comes with preset settings in the printer, the first print I made was with Creality Ender PLA using the printer's default settings. I observed ringing on the surface, unexpected. I reprinted the model with Creality's Hyper PLA using the same settings, hoping for a different outcome. There has been some improvement on the surface, but I'm unable to say that it is generally satisfactory overall. When brands launch fast printers, they typically base it on this model. Here's our printer doing it in about 15 mins, 18 mins, 20 mins. But when they say this, they usually don't share their other settings with us. In my opinion, it seems like Creality has given a value slightly above the quality of a 0.25 millimeters layer thickness here, maybe to keep the time short. And of course, the model is small, and since the layer quality is a bit thick, I think the printer had a little delay in cooling it down, and ripples started to form on the surface. This is just my guess. When I printed it with my own settings using Creality Hyper PLA, the result I got in half an hour had nothing to do with the first print. I used a layer quality of 0.2 millimeters or 200 microns. The print came out quite smooth, except for a few minor stringing. What was the reason for wanting to show this? Because most likely when you also get this printer, you'll probably do a trial with a test print. If you find such a result, don't assume there's a problem with the printer. I wanted you to try with your settings. Besides doing speed tests with PLA, I also got three different prints. One of them is like an astronaut passing through the portal. Currently, it's on top of the printer's build plate, an interesting model, also enjoyable to print. I'm observing lines on the surface at certain points. It's not intense or obvious, but since I'll be taking close-up photos, you'll notice it more clearly. Overall, it can be said that the print is pretty good, except for some layer lines and slight waviness on the surface. Well, this was obviously a print taken with a fast and standard PLA, but I always got better results in fast prints with Hyper PLA compared to standard PLA. Let's change from one astronaut to another. This here is a phone holder. I actually have another YouTube channel where I review technology products. The channel name is Try It Guy. I will review the Samsung Galaxy S24 there this month. I wanted to print this stand that caught my eye during the review. Even though the model parts were printed without support, as you see in the table, there was no sagging except for sudden protrusions of 80, 90 degrees. They've done a pretty good job of cooling fans things down here. Overall, it's a pretty nice print. Here I can say that I printed the print with the standard speeds and settings of Creality print software and achieved a completely flawless result. S24, the base model of Samsung's flagship series. If you want to watch the review of this phone, you can subscribe to the Try It Guy channel and turn on notifications. Believe me, I'm examining these technological products as thoroughly as 3D printers. I'll be waiting for you at the channel, and I'm moving on to the next printing, actually. You can call this both a decorative and functional print. You can utilize it as a decorative piece or as a holder for headphones in its existing condition. The model I downloaded from STL Flix was designed like that. The surface quality looks pretty good. I don't see any printing errors. In this print, I once again used the default settings of the Creality print software. I will also show it on the screen. Speed changes between 200, 300 millimeters per second. When scrutinizing the print details, in my view, it doesn't seem like it was printed at 200, 300 millimeters per second, but rather at much lower speeds, yielding a pleasing outcome. After that, I also worked with ABS PTG and TPU materials. I got a 40x40 Sigma profile print with ABS. We may not always need metal durability in projects. Even though I'm getting this print as an example, I think it can be used quite well in projects after the print is taken. When it comes to surface quality, it's absolutely flawless. When it's this shade of gray, I can say it has a bit of a metallic vibe. ABS is actually not an ideal material for open cases 3D printers. However, under suitable conditions, printing can also be done by applying glue to the painting plate. I executed the same procedure and managed to achieve a flawless ABS print without any lifting problems from the corners of the object. I printed a functional model that I could use on the printer with PTG. You can attach this part to the profile of the printer and place any useful tools on it. The surface quality is very successful. There is a slight distortion at the top of the triangle section where the chisel will be placed. Besides that, everything is good. There's no sign of a nozzle on the top surface. It appears very sleek and lovely. The print I made with TPU, a flexible filament, is also a functional piece. This is a GoPro case. TPU is perfect for producing covers and cases for electronic components like this and that. Of course, printing is not always easy for TPU, but I did not encounter any serious problems. With minor imperfections, I'll show you up close. No major issues encountered. Overall, a good print. Especially when I look at the top surface, there is no nozzle mark, just like in PTG. A pretty smooth and beautiful surface has emerged. I've used different types of Creality printers with Sprite extruder before. I didn't have any problems with those printers when I printed TPU. I continued in the same way in KE as well. We've arrived at the must-have speed test for fast printers. I worked at speeds of 50, 150, 250, and 500 millimeters per second on the same model. I noted that the printer's max acceleration is 8,000 millimeters per second squared. As we raised the speed, I also increased the acceleration proportionally. I didn't differentiate this in aspects like the model's inner wall, outer wall, or filling. I did it so speed and acceleration remain consistent on all surfaces. Also a Roman figure, only the head part is in the shape of a skull. In this video, I've used the same concept repeatedly. Just now, astronauts were going in pairs. Currently, it is Roman figures. This model was comprised of three components, the base, the body, and the head. Now let's break it down into pieces and evaluate them side by side to see differences. First of all, let's start with basics. There are only a few differences in the speeds. I made a serious attempt to find something to demonstrate to you, and all I could perceive were indistinct vibrations in circular dots. Honestly, I'm not sure how much it will be perceived even in photos, and there's a slight visibility in the nozzle marks on the flat surfaces at the top. As speed increases, tracks have also increased at a low level. Speed effects on the hull are a bit more. Generally, it's still slightly less, but relatively more based on the rule. For example, this part, lines have become more pronounced as speed increases. At speeds of 50 and 150 millimeters per second, there are no gaps visible, but at speeds of 250 and 500 millimeters per second, slight lines and gaps start to appear. When observing the smooth body parts, I noticed that with increasing speed, vibration effects became slightly more noticeable. In the front, there's this outfit that goes over her shoulder. What can we say, you know, like in a cloak-like outfit, there were slight ripples as the speed increased. The cake layers are becoming more pronounced. There's a small human face in the middle of your chest. Similarly, as the speed increases, the vibration effects and layer traces have become more pronounced. But like in every point, it's hard to notice, and at a low level, in the head part, or rather in that skull part, a similar situation is also at hand. No more delay, let me show you the details here, because I'm going to reiterate similar things once again. Results are good. If they show me these pieces, I wouldn't know which is taken at 50 millimeters per second and which is taken at 500 millimeters per second. But I can try to make predictions by looking at very tiny details. It's a nice result that the printing time has decreased from 7 hours and 8 minutes to 4 hours at a speed of 50 millimeters per second to 500 millimeters per second on such a figure without compromising too much on quality. In general, I like the printer. I believe it passed the speed tests quite successfully. There were two specific points that I was stuck on and had question marks in my head about in KE. One of these is that the top profile is made of plastic. The second one is a metal profile that you can only see when you open the bottom cover of the printer. The vertical profiles of the printer are directly linked to this metal piece, and it actually does not have any carrier feature. Only profiles are pinned to this. This piece is just sitting directly on the plastic body. This is an unusual system from Creality. Although Creality typically uses plastic for the bodies of their devices, they incorporate metal profiles internally. I'm thinking if this creates a disadvantage, especially in high-speed prints, but I didn't encounter any problems. In fact, I believe that the plastic body and frame have a slightly better ability to absorb vibrations compared to the metal body and frame. However, here's the issue. If the printer continues to operate at high speeds, such as 400 to 500 mm per second, there is a possibility of experiencing slight flexing in these plastic components over time, which has the potential to have a negative impact on the quality of the prints. If it were me, I would use the standard print settings I just showed you with this printer as the maximum print speed. If I were in a hurry, I would print at speeds of 400, 500 millimeters per second. To maximize printer usage and lifespan, I'd enhance efficiency and minimize wear through strategic utilization. Actually, what I'm saying is true for all fast printers, but I wanted to make this suggestion because there are a bit too many plastic parts on this printer. The remote connection feature works just fine, like all the Creality printers I've been using lately. I didn't have a camera on hand, so I didn't have a chance to try it out, but it's nice to be able to integrate it into Creality's optional AI camera. I think there are a few reasons why we don't see vibration effects in prints. One shot is about 8,000 millimeters per second squared. This is not a very aggressive value, and it is a very logical value for a Cartesian system that moves on the y-axis. Furthermore, the table's movement on steel rollers and the lightweight print head's movement on a linear rail contribute to the printer's enhanced stability during rapid movements. Also, when attaching this part to the printer among the products with vibration sensor as an option to prevent vibration effects, you can further reduce the effects and increase the possibility of high-quality prints. One of the questions I often hear from followers of the channel is either I want a printer for hobby purposes or I want to learn this technology as I will use a printer for the first time, but I don't want to invest too much. Well, if you ask me, I'd recommend the Creality Ender3 V3 KE printer. It's just the perfect printer for you. It's what I would call an entry level. It doesn't bother the user with leveling the build plate, which I found quite successful. It was successful in all prints. A compact printer with a printing area sufficient for many projects. That's why I recommend it to hobby users, those who want to learn how to use a 3D printer for the first time, or those looking for a relatively economical device compared to other printers. Here's what I have to say about my Ender3 version 3KE. That's about it. I hope it was a review that you enjoyed. I'm waiting to hear your thoughts and opinions on the printer in the comments. Wishing you a smooth printer and flawless prints. See you in the next video. Take care.